Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. O God, the King Eternal, whose light divides the day from the night, and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all our own desires. Incline our hearts to heed your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace. That having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, the night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, open our lips. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let's sing together with the Magdalene. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence in thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout in the songs. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all. In his hands are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today we depart into his place. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. During our time together in chapel, we had an opportunity to focus on our Episcopal identity and our core values. Let me say our core values again. Wisdom, integrity, service, excellence, and reverence. This time also gives us an opportunity to consider all of our plans for the day, to pause during the middle of our day, and to be grateful. Today we hear from one of our cherished seniors. We remember during this time that at TMI, all are welcome.
Welcome for Ian Senior Chapel Talk. some depression stuff around 7 years ago. But now I've almost to the top of my life. I remember always being physically tired and then sitting in training after middle school and much of high school. I would regularly fall asleep on the car at home, and sometimes I would not get to my bed in conjunction to make up for my lack of sleep, granted natural sleep for hours. Insomnia, but a persistent inability to fall asleep or stay asleep, started to affect everything in my life. I felt victim to this nasty, corrosive cycle of sleepless nights and dreary days, living in a semi-lucid state. The only reminder of the passing of time was the end of the quarter in school. This was because I always had uncompleted work at the time, sometimes ranging from 20 to 40 assignments to make up in a couple of days, but I almost always got them turned in at the compromise of my already weakened mental health. My unhealthy habits stemming from untreated insomnia continued throughout the later years of middle school and early years of high school. They went unchanged because I could always make up the work. I never failed, so I never learned. When the COVID-19 pandemic started my physical and social interactions with many people other than my immediate family, my well-being worsened. I found myself sinking under the waves, unable to swim toward the surface no matter how hard I tried. My general experience of anxiety and stress was amplified tenfold. But my new situation, my new expectations, and of course, my consistent failures to live up to set expectations. At times, I would question my reason to live, often saying to myself, if my foreseeable future is filled with dissatisfaction and self-imposed suffering, why not want to spare myself the suffering? If I am a burden to others as well as myself, why not spare the world from my burden? Looking back on this obviously self-destructive mentality, and I realize that it's not my own. Similarly, the amount of love you receive from others does not matter if you do not love yourself. My romanticization, living in the world of my brain, impeded my ability to stand stable and prepared for my mindset, where I would complete specific actions to guarantee my own success. I started to live with an attitude of whatever happens, happens. While this did eliminate the majority of the stress and anxiety, I felt the mindset simultaneously acted as a word between my potential and my actual ability to succeed. Whether it be academic or extracurricular. I started to receive comments along the lines of, if you input more effort into this, you could really excel at it, or if you just try it once, you could really be really good at this. From not only my academic teachers, but my music teachers and coaches as well, hearing this only made me fall deeper into the trench of self-loathing. Because of these constant reminders of what I could potentially be and how I failed to live up to my potential, I hit rock bottom. Every day, I continued living, felt like some sort of cruel torture, an act of war on my already serotonin depleted neurons. I rejected the failure I had become, so I saw the way out. It was around this time, the time when I accepted being dragged to the bottom of the ocean, complacent about my eventual destiny to die, that I received tragic news from all over Europe. On October 10th, 2021, me and Uber
Making his way up.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Seniors.